Welcome to this course on phase field modeling. In the last module, we talked about certain thermodynamic models which are known as solution models. Specifically, we discussed ideal solution and regular solution model. So, in this lecture, we are going to start from those models and what is it that we can understand in terms of phase equilibria in binary systems. So, to do that, let me just recall what is it that we did in the last class in the first section of this module. In the last lecture, we said that we are considering a binary system and we are considering it to be at atmospheric pressure, and then as a function of temperature, what happens to the free energy in case you are mixing these two different types of atoms on a particular lattice. So, this is the problem that we were looking at. So, we took a lattice like this, okay, and we decided to put some number of A atoms and some number of B atoms on this lattice, and the number of A atoms was Na, the number of B atoms was Nb, and Na plus Nb put together is N. That is the total number of sites that are available here, and I represented A atoms by open circles and B atoms by closed circles. Okay. So you put atoms like this, and there are many different ways in which you can arrange these atoms on this lattice, and we discussed ways of arranging and what is the energy, free energy associated with mixing the A and B type of atoms on a lattice like this. So, that is basically what the regular solution model tries to do. In that, finally, we derived an expression under certain approximations. So, the approximation was that atoms are distributed randomly on this lattice, which was used to calculate the configurational entropy, and we said that configurational entropy is the only entropy contribution. And we also said that the bond energies associated with BB bonds, AA bonds and AB bonds are different. So, we defined a parameter called epsilon, which was nothing but the difference between an AB bond minus average of AA BB bonds. Okay. So, in terms of these quantities, we defined and epsilon was related to the enthalpy of mixing through some numbers like Avogadro number, the number of nearest neighbors in the particular crystal structure and so on. So, we defined, finally, we showed that the free energy of mixing, that is if you take A atoms and they are by themselves and B atoms they are by themselves, and you calculate the free energy, and now you put them together in a given lattice and distribute A and B atoms on the lattice, you calculate the free energy, take the difference between the two free energies, and that free energy is known as delta G mix, because this is the excess free energy associated with mixing. That is, if you had done this and you calculated the total free energy and you subtracted out the initial free energy when A and B atoms were on their own lattice, the difference is this quantity, and this we showed to be equal to the free energy of the enthalpy of mixing minus temperature times the entropy of mixing, and the entropy is purely configurational. So, when we did that, we also showed that this happens to be using regular solution model a quantity like this omega, which is known as the regular solution parameter, times composition xb, which is defined as nb by n 1 minus xb plus R, where R is the universal gas constant, T, which is the absolute temperature, times xB log xB plus 1 minus xB log 1 minus xB. So, from this expression, we argued that at higher temperatures, when the temperature dependent term is dominant, then the enthalpy of mixing does not play a key role. The system chooses a configuration which is dominated by entropy, and because entropy would prefer a random distribution, you form random solid solution. So, at higher temperatures, irrespective of what omega is, you will always find that it forms random solutions. Now there are three cases that you can think of for omega. Omega can be negative, omega can be positive, omega can be 0. If omega is 0, then we call that as ideal solution, because omega is related to the difference between AB bond energies and AABB bond energies, the average of. So if this quantity is 0, that means on the average we do not distinguish between AB bonds and AABB bonds, which means the system does not distinguish between A and B type of atoms. So in that case also this contribution becomes 0, so because omega is 0, then it is exactly like the system which is only dominated by entropy, and because entropy prefers random solid solution, you will form random solid solution. But the more interesting cases are the ones in which omega is not 0 and it is either negative or positive. And in those two cases, if it is negative, then the system forms what is known as an ordered solid solution. If it is positive, then the system phase separates. Okay. So we are going to use this expression as the starting point, and in the next part of this module, we will discuss how this phase separation happens, or why it happens, and how do we understand this process. Thank you.